Stephen Miles has been sworn in as Queensland's 40th Premier following a unanimous Labor Party room vote. The former Deputy Premier is promising a new chapter as the government's frontbench undergoes its biggest shake-up in almost a decade.
Waving in a new era. A united front for Premier Stephen Miles and his new right-hand man. Given a long-standing ovation and the hugs kept coming.
I don't have time to hug you all, but...
Embraced by Labor colleagues to lead the party he joined when he was still in high school, elected unopposed and unanimously by the party room.
My focus as Premier is 100% on being the Premier.
We have a great opportunity to build on the legacy of Anastasia Palaszczuk.
From Parliament House, history beckoned, leaving 1 William Street in the CBD in a low-key convoy, taking the 15-minute drive to 168 Fernberg Road, Paddington. Through the gates of Government House, the boy from Brisbane had arrived.
Thank you. G'day. Good to see you.
Making the journey with him, his biggest supporters, his wife Kim and their 3 children, Sam, Aidan and Bridie. For the Governor of Queensland, Jeanette Young, it also marked a milestone. It's the first time she's had a Premier to officially swear in since taking on the role. The 46-year-old Queensland's 40th Premier. The first of his family to go to university on a scholarship from Wayne Goss. He studied journalism and politics, completing a PhD on trade union renewal. Now his sight sets on renewing a third-term government.
For the first time in almost 9 years, there's a new leader on the steps of Government House. Stephen Miles insists he'll be a Premier who listens as he faces pressure to refocus the government ahead of the election.
With a re-election slogan ready to go...
Well, this is a fresher government with a fresh approach.
And a team of fresh ministers.
5 new ministers, the most number of fresh faces in a government since we were elected.
Pine Rivers MP Nikki Boyd, Bundamba MP Lance McCallum entering the front bench from the left. From the right faction, Jordan MP Cherise Mullen, Aspley MP Bart Malish and Cairns MP Michael Healy, replacing 4 outgoing MPs, including the former Premier and Transport Minister Mark Bailey.
We wanted to have fresh faces. To do that, some people needed to stand aside.
This afternoon, outlining a new chapter for Queensland, the conservationist and former Environment Minister declaring an ambitious climate target.
We will reduce Queensland's emissions by 75% by 2035.
Also committing to more satellite hospitals, bringing back a leadership forum to unite businesses with a call to arms to tackle youth crime.
I can't fix the youth crime problem on my own.
Ending on a promise to his family.
Aidan and Sam and Bridie, I promise to still try to get to some of your soccer and cricket games. I hope I can make you proud.
And for the rest of Queensland,
I hope I can leave Queensland an even better place.
With an enormous job ahead.
Well, he's already set a cracking pace this week, and tomorrow Stephen Miles is expected to start one-on-one meetings with his ministers. He'll then finalise and announce their roles in Cabinet on Monday. They will be under pressure to perform. Poll after poll has been indicating Labor is headed for defeat next October.
Big job ahead. Thank you, Marlena.